Welcome back to Albany County Fasteners, Fasteners 101. I'm Bob, and today we're going to be talking about nuts and lock nuts. So let's get started. So I have a whole bunch of nuts on my table. I have, we're going to start basically with finished nuts, next into lock nuts, and then into specialty nuts, which will follow right after. And then we're going to do a couple of demonstrations. So the first I have up were two machine nuts. Okay, and these machine nuts, to the left, I have a standard machine nut. And to the right, I have a small pattern machine nut. Now those two machine nuts, they will take the same screw, but the only difference is the outside circumference. Obviously, small patterns are made for very tight areas for using those screws or the nuts on very small locations that are tight. So that's machine screw nuts. Now I have finished nuts and jam. So to the left, I have a finished nut, which is standard finished nut. That's the most typical, widely used nut on the market. And this is what they call a jam nut. Jam nut's about half the size of a regular finished nut in height. Otherwise, the circumference and everything else is the same. You use the same wrench to apply the nut and to remove the nut. Next one I have is, again, a finished nut, but this finished nut and jam nut, to the left I have a finished nut, and to the right I have a jam nut. And jam nuts, just to give you what these do, you use two nuts together and then you tighten them up against each other. That's why they call them jam nuts. You use them together, you tighten them up, and I'll show you, I'll do a demonstration of that also. But typically, that's how they're used. They're also used in tight areas where you can't have a full-size nut. So what you have here with this jam nut and this finish nut is, this is what we call a heavy finish nut and a heavy jam nut. And how you tell the difference, here's a standard finish nut. Okay, to the left is a standard and this is a heavy finish nut. So you can see the difference in the outside diameter, the thickness of the nut. So this heavy nut is going to take a larger wrench, even though it's the same size bolt that would go through that nut. This is a heavy jam nut. So this is a standard to the left, and to the right is the heavy jam nut. So you can see the substantial difference in that. And there's projects that require that type of that nut as specified. So those two, as I said, are both finish and jam nut, heavy. Next I have, these are square nuts. So you'll see this square nut to the left, they're both basically square nuts. The one on the left has bevels on the ends, on one side only. On the opposite side, it doesn't have any bevels. You can see that over here, you see it's flat, and then over here you can see the bevels. And on this smaller square nut, there is no bevels at all. It's just sliced nut, and that's it. The bevels start at 1/4-20. So anywhere from, I believe it's the square nut starts at 6/32 up to 10 32, and those will have no bevels on them. However, once you get above that, you will see these bevels on the top edge. The next set of nuts I have are the locking nuts. So we're moving from finished nuts to locking nuts. These are nylon insert lock nuts. You can see in here, they have a nylon insert. That's why they call them nylon insert. And what happens is when you put the bolt through, it starts to thread the nylon and then puts pressure on the screw and prevents it from vibrating loose. This is a nylon jam nut. So this is the same nut, nylon locking, but in a jam nut, so it's low profile. And you can see the difference between them. So this would be your standard, this would be your jam. I'm gonna keep these out. Now I have, same thing, nylon jam nuts, okay? However, these are what they call heavy nylon jam nuts, okay? So you can see here the difference in the standards, and here you can see the difference in the jams. I can get a stay, yep, perfect. So you can see here the difference, and you can tell by the backside mainly. So when you want to look at and distinguish what's different, you can see the meat that's on a heavy nylon lock nut versus a standard. You can see the wall is much thinner on a standard nut. Obviously, you have to have the room to put this on. And that also stands for the jam nut, nylon locking jam nut. It's the same thing. So that right there, as you can see, the difference between them, this is the jam nut, heavy, and this is the standard. And now I'm gonna move on to, they call this a stover. This also is called prevailing torque locking nut. So it has a locking mechanism that's built into this cone, and as you put it on, it starts to act like a locking nut. I'm going to demonstrate that one also for you. This is a two-way nut. So how do you tell a two-way nut? Two-way nut has this little marking in the center. Little marking in the center. See it there? It's almost like a punch right in the center. And that shows that that's a two-way. So it's locking two-way, no matter you put it on or off. Once you start to screw up to that size, it will start to lock. So I just reached it now. I'm not gonna continue, but either way I put this on, it's going to start locking. They call it a two-way locking nut. The next one I have is a serrated flange nut. This is a nut. It has an integral flange built into it, and on the backside, you can see that it's serrated. That's usually used in applications where you have some type of metal sheeting or something that has metal, and you tighten it down, and those serrations prevent it from backing off. So that's a serrated lock nut. Then we have, as another lock nut, this is called a K lock nut or Kipps lock nut. And these have these little wings that are here, and this is a free rolling washer lock nut. So those little wings get tightened, and the key to this is not to over tighten it. Once you over tighten this, it's no longer a lock nut, and that free rolling washer gets crushed and it just doesn't work for you anymore. So the key to this is not to torque it down too tight. Very common. This is a very common lock nut. Then we have, this is a left hand. I'm getting into the specialty items now. So I'm gonna start showing you some special nuts. This is what they call a left hand jam nut. You see it's a low profile. Okay, the only way you can tell left hand is it has an arrow that is right there, and that arrow shows it turning to the left. And that's the only way you're going to know when you have a left hand nut. You got to look for that arrow. If you have that arrow exists, then it's a left hand nut. There's a wing nut. Obviously very commonly used swing nuts for many different types of applications. This nut, I'm gonna show you this one first. This is a reducer. So you can see on one side, it has 3/8, 16, and this side has 1/2 inch 13. So you can literally go, if you had some threaded rod and you want to reduce it down to a smaller size, or the opposite, where you want it to go from 1/2 13 to 3/8 16, you'd use this reduce coupling nut, they call it. And that's the way that would work there. And this is a standard coupling nut. They come in various sizes and lengths, different thread pitches, fine, coarse thread. All these items I'm showing you do come in coarse and fine thread. This is a knurled nut, commonly used in chandeliers, tattoo machines, many different types of finished applications these are used in. These are the type of things you put on with your thumbs. Don't usually use a wrench on this type of a nut. That's the same thing with a wing nut. Wing nuts are always used for thumbs. No wrenches involved in these nuts. Next I have are cap nuts. So there's two different types of cap nuts. So you have low profile, high crown, and then you have what they call an acorn nut, and that's a little substantial more in height. So those are the cap nuts. I have here what they call a T-nut. T-nuts are used mostly in wood. Most common, they do use it in plastics also. T-nut is made to go in, the hole is drilled into the wood or into a plastic product. And then these prongs that you see here, they come in 3-prong, 4-prong. This particular one has 4 prongs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 prongs. And then it has this barrel, they call this a barrel. And you push it into the hole that you drilled, and then you suck the screw in, and this flattens right out with the wood, typically. Very commonly used nut. Next one I have, this is called a tri-groove nut. It has 3 grooves on this. 1, 2, 3. There's 3 grooves in here. This is a security nut. This is to prevent anybody from going, trying to put a wrench on it. It's very hard to put a wrench, but never mind pick it up. But it's hard to put a wrench on this nut. You probably put a vice grip on it and it'll hold it and you'll get it off. But it's really a deterrent for anybody walking by who wants to try and take something. That's what it's mainly used for. And it takes a special socket that clips, that goes over this nut and locks into those three grooves to be able to tighten it on. Then we have a castle nut. These are typically used in cars. You'll find them on axles when they hold on wheels and bearings, rotors. And we're going to demonstrate this one also for you, whereas we're going to drill out a bolt, slide the cotter pin in to show you how this is locked in place. And then the final nylon lock nut I have, which this one's very interesting. This is a standard nylon lock nut with the nylon insert. And this nut is what they call pre-waxed. It's waxed to prevent any gulling. So gulling gets into where your nut seizes onto the bolt and you can't go any further. And the only thing that starts to happen is either you snap the bolt or snap the nut. So we're gonna demonstrate that we'll have no gulling with this particular waxed insert lock nut. This is a great product for manufacturing production. You don't have to put any anti-seize onto the nuts or screws. So this will save yourself a lot of time. There you go. Subscribe, like, comment. Visit us at albanycountyfasteners.com for 50,000 SKUs right off the rack, ready to ship. We look forward to seeing you in our next video.